Oscar goes to Benicio del Toro in Craft.
I'm sad, honestly, I'm sad.
Seriously, I don't know what to say.
Hello, little friends. It's Alessandro again, and welcome back to Uplivity Channel. In this episode, I'm not going to show you how to win an Oscar, of course. But I can definitely help you guys before your next travel adventure to Pukok Island in Vietnam. In fact, in this video I'll share with you some information I'm sure you want to know about the cost of life of this spectacular island. For example, you might want to know how much accommodations, food and drinks cost in Pukok Island, so you will have a better idea before you go there. I had a wonderful time in Pukok Island, and I seriously traveled like a pro over there by spending little money and getting the most out. So watch this video to the end, and don't forget to leave your comment and to subscribe to Uplivity Channel. Enjoy!
Hey guys, good morning. Good morning everyone, welcome back to Pukok Island and welcome back to Uplivity Channel. I got the bill of our staying here at Sun and Wind Resort in Pukok. This is the final price we paid for 5 days, because we got here the 28th, and as you know, we extended our staying for until the 2nd, which is today. So this is the price, 6,630,000 Vietnamese dong, which includes the room, the motorbike, and the taxi, pick up and drop off. It's really, really good price, really, really cheap. And it's a really good place. I really recommend you to come to this building, to this bungalow. They are basically bungalows. Sorry for the voice, but yesterday night was a little bit difficult. See you later, guys. Thanks for watching. Ciao from Alessandro.
Okay guys, that was just an overview of one accommodation and renting a motorbike from my personal experience. Depending on your budget, you can find different type of accommodations in Pukok Island, from a $10 per night hostel to a $200 per night 5-star resort. It's up to you. But for the motorbike, you don't need to spend more than $7 per day, otherwise they are trying to rip you off. So now let's talk about the average price for food, drinks and other needs while you are traveling to Pukok Island. What do you usually have for breakfast? I always start my days with a hot cup of black coffee. Here in Pukok Island, the quality of coffee is really good. I found that the average price for an espresso is only $1 and $2 for a cappuccino. Then you can find different type of pastries like standard croissant and chocolate croissant. However, if you prefer a sandwich or a seafood fried rice or an egg noodles plate, they all cost around $5. You can find almost anything in Pukok Island. Cheeseburgers, french fries, spaghetti bolognese and pizza. But what I really loved in this island was the seafood. It's so fresh and healthy and of course so cheap. For example, I only spent $8 for a grilled fish of the day or a tamarind prawns plate. My mouth is watering if I think about it. What about alcohol? Guess what? It's cheap in Pukok Island. You will only spend a little bucks for a beer, but popular cocktails and shots like tequila boom boom are more expensive. You are likely to spend around $10 for one drink. Are you going to buy a souvenir before you leave? I really recommend to buy the classic Vietnamese hat, like I did, for $6. What else? On average, petrol stations sell the fuel at 0.85 US dollars per liter. And if you are renting a motorbike, make sure to fill its tank during the day, as the petrol stations in the island don't remain open at night. There are just a few laundries in the island. I was lucky because I found one laundry near the bungalow where I stayed. As you can see, I only paid 50,000 dong for washing two full bags of clothes, which is the equivalent of 2.50 US dollars. Okay guys, this was an overview of the general prices in Phukok Island. I can assure you that more or less, this is how much you are going to spend for these needs. Even though I didn't do any tour and activities such as snorkeling or surfing, I simply discovered the island on board a motorbike and I had a fantastic experience. So if you want to do tours and other activities, bear in mind that they are not for free in Phukok Island, like in other places in the world. Anyway, I have to confess that I truly desire to revisit this little piece of paradise as soon as possible. I can't wait. Okay guys, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it. Happy travels, my friends. See you soon. Ciao!